Hi friends, as you guys are aware, my name is Professor Heenal Furia. I'm also known as Professor Heenal Shah. I like to share a little bit about me before, you know, we begin with this beautiful journey of learning GST. So I basically cleared my final CA exam in 2012, and post that I joined a Big Four, and I was very fortunate that, you know, I got so many opportunities to work in the corporate world and, you know, learn so many things. So I've worked with EY, and then I went ahead and I was a tax team leader pan India for Interpublic Group, which is again, you know, one of the Big Fours in the media world. So, you know, I have had so much of, the journey has been so beautiful. Even when I was a CA student, I got to learn so many things. And even after clearing CA, I'm still learning. I'm still learning so many new things every day. So I'm sure that, you know, you guys are also going to learn from me, you know, from my whatever rich experience I've had. I'm sure you guys, it's going to, you know, add on to your knowledge. And maybe I'll be able to answer your queries also much better. So a few of you must be knowing me as I've graduated from HR college, and I was a visiting faculty in HR college. I used to teach taxation over there. And now I have started this new journey of, you know, teaching you guys GST at the inter level. So before I tell you more about, you know, the way I've written my textbook, or, you know, the way I've explained stuff and, you know, recorded my video lectures, I like to share a few ways, you know, where you can, you know, you can comment or maybe ask questions, or, you know, maybe, you know, connect with me, join me. So the first is I have I'm on FB in the name of CA Heenal Furia. You guys can also find my FB page, which goes in the name of GST Funda. Then I have a YouTube channel, which is also of the same name, GST Funda. And obviously it has Professor Heenal Furia also. So you can search on YouTube and find me there. And I have joined Coppergate actually for my video lectures. So I have a tie up with Coppergate. So if you guys are interested in, you know, buying my video lectures, then here's where you get the stuff. And they also have a YouTube channel, so you can find me there as well. So looking forward to hear from you. Okay, now let's first talk about the paper pattern, because that is the most important thing. The main aim for a CA student is to obviously clear his exams, and if you're my student, then you have to even get good marks in it, right? So let's start with the paper pattern. First, I'll talk about the paper pattern of the old course, theek hai? And then we'll talk about the new course as well. So GST is comes under paper 4 taxation. So section A is income tax, as you guys are aware, which is for 50 marks. And section B is indirect tax, or GST. Like, you know, when I was a student, we had service tax, we had VAT, we had excise, we had customs. So the good news for you guys is that you guys just have GST. That's it. You'll have a little bit of customs, but that's, you know, in the final level, not right now. So it's very scoring. You have to gain the maximum marks over here. This is one paper in which you can score like super. So now coming back to the paper pattern, it's divided into two. There is part one and part B. The part one has MCQs, okay, which are for 15 marks. And you get a question paper and you get OMR sheets. Just mein aapko tick karke, fill karke, you have to give it along with your question paper. So that is part one. And mostly the MCQs are 1 marks, but sometimes, you know, depending on the question, they come for 2 marks also. So this is extremely scoring, and you guys have to score the maximum. Now I have an entire chapter dedicated on MCQs, where I have around, you know, 150 MCQs. 50% of them are, you know, chapter wise, and 50% is more like your test for you guys. Okay, so make sure you score the maximum in MCQs. Okay, as you guys are aware that, you know, in few of the papers there is an assessment of 30 and 70. Just mein 30% is your MCQs and 70% is your sums or practicals or theory, the way you say. Okay, now coming back to part two. Part two is for, you know, 35 marks, okay? Because 15 marks is there, you have MCQs over there. So, ye 35 marks kaise divided hai? First question is question 6, which is compulsory, okay? Most of the time, this is a sums wala question, ya practical question that you say. But obviously, you have to give explanation to why यू आर एडिंग और सब्ट्रैक्टिंग या यू नो डिपेंडिंग ऑन वट एवर द सम इज. तो अब थ्योरी तो थोड़ा बहुत आपको लिखना ही पड़ेगा. सो ऑब्वियसली द फर्स्ट फोकस when I teach you guys is going to be theory, and then we'll be moving to practical sums. So theory is very important because in the sums also you have to give explanations. To give those explanations you have to know your theory, correct? Okay, now once you're done with question number 6, then you have 4 questions, okay, from 7 to 10. Isme se aapko koi 3 karna hai, theek hai? You don't have to do all, you have to attempt only 3. And most cases mein जो क्वेश्चन नंबर 10 है वो थ्योरी क्वेश्चन रहता है मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम, बट यू नो द इंस्टीट्यूट, दे कैन चेंज वॉट एवर दे वॉन्ट. एंड द रिमेनिंग जो 3 क्वेश्चन है लाइक 7, 8 एंड 9, देर कुड बी अ मिक्सचर ऑफ यू नो ओनली थ्योरी, सम्स एंड थ्योरी, या दोनों यू नो सिर्फ सम्स, डिपेंडिंग ऑन वॉट एवर द इंस्टीट्यूट फील्स लाइक. सो बेसिकली दैट. सो माई टारगेट ओवर हियर इज दैट यू गाइस शुड स्कोर द मैक्सिमम in this subject, right? Because it's really simple at least IPCC level. Next we're going to talk about new course. So as you guys are aware, new course mein jo pehle 50 marks ka tha abhi 40 marks hai, right? So part 1 is again MCQs jaise maine aapko bataya, but over here it's only for 12 marks, okay, instead of 15 marks which is there in the old course. Part 2 has only 4 questions over here. The 5th question is compulsory 8 marks ke liye. Most of the times there is a practical question, या तो you know sums as you say, but obviously again over here also you have to give explanations. Then you have 3 questions जिसमें से आपको 2 करना है. Most of the times 8 question number 8 है वो theory का रहता है, ठीक है? And it's for obviously 10 marks, so they can bifurcate it the way they like it. And the remaining 2 questions, that is 6 and 7, could be only theory, could be only sums, could be mixture. It depends on whatever they want. So basically here's the breakup, 12, 8 and 20. This is the way you look at it. Okay. Now I'll take you through the index, okay, so that you guys can get an understanding how we are going to progress, you know, as we go ahead with learning all the chapters. Now friends, this is what the index looks like. So basically you have 10 chapters, okay. In the first chapter we're going to discuss about you know how GST was brought about in India. I'm going to talk about the entire roadmap and everything. Then we'll go to chapter number 2, which talks about the supply under GST, the concept of supply under GST. Then in chapter number 3 we're going to discuss the charge, like how you're supposed to charge GST on the various goods and services. Then chapter 4 we're going to discuss about you know the exemptions that are available from GST. Then 5th chapter we are going to talk about the concept of time and value of supply. Okay, so supply, as I'm sure you guys are aware, is very important in GST. In fact, the entire GST is based on supply. Okay, so this is an important chapter. Then chapter number 6, we're going to discuss about the input tax credit. Okay, in this, we're going to talk about how we can, you know, in which cases you can get input tax credit, you know, what are the criteria to get it, in which cases you can't get it, and how you're supposed to set it off and everything. So we're going to discuss that. Then in chapter number 7, we're going to discuss that, you know, when are you supposed to register under GST and what are the different types of registrations available under GST. Okay, so that's what we're going to discuss. Then in chapter number 8, we're going to discuss about tax invoice, okay, in which we're going to talk about what all things are compulsory in a tax invoice. There is no a particular format given by GST. GST Act, but obviously there are important points which have to be mentioned on the invoice. Then also we are going to discuss about credit, debit notes and e-way bills. Okay, there is one more thing that we are going to discuss, that is bill of supply. So in the cases where you cannot issue a tax invoice, you have to issue bill of supply. So that is also part of it. Then there is chapter number 9, which talks about payment of tax, like you know how you are going to pay tax. It talks about you know cash ledger, electronic ledger, etc. Then we're going to talk about chapter number 10, in which we're going to discuss the various types of returns that are there under GST, and you know what is the due date, how do you go, you know, how do you file them, and etc. Then chapter number 11, which is important, I told you, it's basically MCQs, which is very important for you to score great marks. Okay. And last chapter, chapter number 12, it has a few important points which you need to see before the exams. It's like, you know, last minute revision kind of a thing. And I've also attached the past examination paper so that you guys have a look at it. And obviously, you know, I have discussed it at chapter level wise also, but I've attached all the past exam papers so that you guys get an, so that you guys can have a look. Okay, you know, how does the question paper look? What sort of questions come in the exam, etc. Now, two more very important things I like to mention. I'm also visiting faculty at WRC, so you guys must have seen me there also. And yeah, in case if you want to get in touch with me, or you know, if you need require any help in WRC, you guys can get in touch with me. Maybe if you require any other explanations or anything. And there's something I like to share about the video lectures. So as far as the video lectures go, I'm very glad to share with you that I'll complete your entire course within 24 hours. Okay, you heard me right. So obviously the 24 hours that I've told you, I'm going to cover the entire IPCC portion. And obviously after that, it does not cover MCQs because MCQs is a different chapter. But obviously, jitna bhi MCQs hai, sab wo theory mein mera cover ho jata hai. MCQs aapko khud ko karna hai. Jitna aap practice karenge, tohi it's obviously better for you. And tohi aap paper mein fatafat solve karke marks score kar payenge. So MCQs ka aapko jo bhi help chahiye, I will provide you obviously. And you, this is something that you have to practice, practice, practice and practice, as we say. And once 24 hours में आपका जो theory पूरा मैं cover कर दूँगी, उसके बाद again जितने भी sums और ये question paper specially मैंने जो attach किए हैं, I would request you guys to solve it. जितना आप practice 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 करेंगे, उतना ही आप exam में फटाफट लिख पाएंगे, ज़्यादा score कर पाएंगे, and you guys will be so confident about the paper. ठीक है? So I hope to see you guys in the full course video that is available for you guys, and all the very best for your exams. If you need any help, do let me know. I'm always there to help you guys, and all the very best. Thank you.